A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd Jan, on the front page you have Modi asks Citizenship Amendment Act opponents to protest against Pakistan atrocities. So he says that neighbors' treatment of its religious minorities need to be exposed. So of course, if there is any injustice going on in any part, it should be protested against. But that does not mean that Citizenship Amendment Act protests are not to be undertaken. So those protests are also having its stand. Then this is NCLAT decision is a recipe for disaster. Tatas tell Supreme Court. So this is regarding National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, which gave its ruling recently that Cyrus Mistry should be reinstated as chairman of Tata Sons Private Limited. So he is a minority shareholder. His company is a minority shareholder, and he was removed by the group. And now the NCLAT ruling on it is said to be a recipe of disaster by Tatas. So a petition has been filed against the reinstatement of Cyrus Mistry by Tatas now. Then on page 7 you have, won't determine if poem hurts sentiments. So this has been said by investigating committee formed by IIT Kanpur. It said that it would not probe into whether the recital of poem Hum Dekhenge, which is a poem by Pakistani revolutionary Faiz Ahmad Faiz, this poem was recited during campus protests in December 2019. So investigating committee of IIT Kanpur said that it would look into whether if there was any deliberate mischief caused as such, and not whether the poem hurt sentiments. Then below you have Aadhaar must for welfare pension in Orisha. So Orisha government has announced that from April 1, 2020, only beneficiaries with Aadhaar card will be given pension under the National Social Assistance Program and Madhubahu Pension Yojana. Madhubahu Pension Yojana. So this has been the announcement of the government. We had recently seen how there have been starvations as such, to malnutrition, starvation in Orisha tribals because of schemes not reaching them. And also one major reason being that Aadhaar not being available, Aadhaar verification not being done. So here now Aadhaar is being mandatory for these two schemes. On page 8 you have, Kerala deports 4 Russian nationals for visa violations. So Foreign Regional Registration Office under the Bureau of Immigration has deported 4 Russian nationals. So it is said they violated their visa conditions, and you can see here it was said they had arrived in the country on business visa and they partnered with local businessmen to invest in the tourism business. So they themselves came on business visa, and it is said they repeatedly violate visa conditions by seeking employment as bakers and tea makers in hotels and restaurants in the resort locality. On page 9 you have, India records less than 100 tiger deaths for the first time in 3 years. So for the first time in past 3 years, number of tiger deaths in a year in the country have been less than 100. So this is the data from the Ministry of Forest, Environment and Climate Change. So it is said there were 84 cases of tiger deaths in the country and 11 cases of seizures in which tiger is presumed dead on the basis of body parts seized by authorities. So both together the death toll goes to 95. While in 2018 number of tiger deaths was 100. So, and it has been more in previous years too. So now tiger deaths have reduced. They are less than 100 now for the first time in 3 years. And this is, Science Congress takes extra care to avoid pseudoscience. So this is 107th edition of Science Congress, Indian Science Congress in Bengaluru. So here they have taken special care to ensure that pseudoscientific articles or talks did not creep in. Pseudoscience is something which is believed in ancient times culturally, which is put into scientific mold. So here you can see, Kauravas of the Mahabharata were born of the stem cell technology and test tube babies. So this such statements been given, you know, and Ram and Ravan had fought with guided missiles. So such statements been given without any proof or validity, you know, any valid justification or assertion for, as such. So such statements and such things are called pseudoscience. Pseudo means false, false science. Then below you have architects question land use change for Central Vista revamp. So several architects have raised concerns over the center's proposal to change land use of plots in the heart of Lutyens, Delhi, to make way for new Parliament House, residences and office buildings. So this recreational land, public space is being used for such Parliament House purposes. So the architects claim that there is no scientific study done and they have raised concerns over this change, land use change. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is birth pangs. So this is regarding Maharashtra legislative body, actually Maharashtra government as such. So we have Maharashtra Vikas Aghadi, MVA coalition government, which has been formed here. It comprises of three political parties, that is Shiv Sena, NCP and Congress. So now portfolio allocation finally has been completed and you can see 15, 16 and 12 berths respectively have been provided to Shiv Sena, NCP and Congress. So total 43 Council of Ministers have been formed. So the expansion of Council of Ministry took place now after the government has been formed, showing how there have been conflicts and differences in selection of portfolios for various political parties. And second is a weak test. So this is regarding Swachh Sarvekshan. This was also front page news yesterday. So Swachh Sarvekshan 2020 has been undertaken, but the editorial says that it should go beyond symbolism and adopt sustainability. So Swachh Sarvekshan actually ranks cities and the idea is to bring in competition among cities so that they can work better. First and foremost is waste management, in which various urban local bodies have failed, but then how they would manage waste is still not provided for through this survey or Sarvekshan. So that those points are being raised, you can see. Many cities remain clueless on handling their waste. One shocking example being rising mountain of garbage at Ghazipur landfill in Delhi. And even the ranking, it is just symbolism, because Bhopal, which is among the top five cleanest cities as such, under this recently released Swachh Sarvekshan ranking, it is said here millions live with the effect of Bhopal gas disaster of 1984. So how can it be the cleanest city? So questions are being raised. The editorial also says that there are various programs of the government also to put these into effect, what Swachh Sarvekshan seeks to achieve. So one of them mentioned is Amrut, Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation. So it says states have been helped under this scheme to set up facilities necessary to manage waste. So all that is essential. Should go beyond symbolism and adopt sustainability. Then the lead article is In the Ruins of Unilateralism. So this is regarding USA. So we live in a unilateral world where USA is the strongest superpower. But this article says developments in 2019 suggest that the US's ability to shape global politics is clearly receding. So unilateralism is being affected. There are cracks in the NATO. USA has problems with Turkey as such too, which is a member of NATO. And this is when defection is a mere detour of an MLA. So this is regarding how defections which took place in Karnataka and the MLAs came back after elections, by elections which were held. So this article calls for defections when defection takes place, means a member of legislative, a member of any parliamentary body at state level or at central level, if that member of parliament, member of legislative body defects, that is joins another political party or supports any other political party against the whip as such of his own political party, then he would be defecting and that's why his seat would be taken away, his the seat which he has won. So this disqualification on grounds of defection takes place under certain criteria. There are certain criteria which saves defections, like if one third of the party completely joins another party or forms its own party, then it is not defection. So it means defection in bulk is not defection. So such provisions are there in the anti-defection law of the country. So what this article is calling for is that when there's defection, then there should be disqualification for 6 years. Means even if they're disqualified, they're disqualified for the term for which they were appointed. But recently we saw in Karnataka that they were they were disqualified for the term appointed, but that term soon ended because the seats became vacant and by-elections were held, and those same defecting MLAs were appointed again or were elected again. So what this article is calling for is that in such cases, disqualification should be there for completely for 6 years. So Kerala-like incident would not take place. Then on the op-ed page, you have the on Fridays, you have this parley coverage in which an important question is asked. So today it is, should the finance minister tweak direct taxes to spur economy? So the viewpoint which comes forth is that direct taxes, if they are reduced to, they are not going to impact slowdown, but they may provide some relief to the salaried class. And below you have here, minimizing the housing divide. So this talks about how India requires an integrated housing development strategy for the rural context too. So provision of urban amenities to rural areas, Pura scheme was also brought forth, which was a vision of former president APJ Abdul Kalam. So providing urban amenities in rural areas is one aspect which has been highlighted here for integrated housing development strategy. Then on page 12, you have Air Defense Command plan on. So this is now Chief of Defense Staff, General Bipin Rawat. He has outlined priorities at talks with headquarters integrated defense staff. So Air Defense Command will be planned is what is being stated. Then below you have India-Nepal to hold talks on Kalapani. So Nepal and India will resolve the Kalapani border issue through dialogue. So this is a region which is a dispute between India and Nepal. So India claims it belongs to it, India, and the recent maps which have been made, they depicted Kalapani in Indian territory. These were the recent maps released after the formation of two latest union territories of India, that is Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So Kalapani was shown in Uttarakhand as such, and Nepal claims it to be belonging to itself. So Nepal had raised concerns over these latest maps. On page 13, you have 999 Bangladeshis were in India illegally, says border force head. So this is around 1000 Bangladeshi nationals. It is said they were detained in Bangladesh in 2019 for living in India illegally, and the Bangladesh government has initiated legal proceedings against them. So they were arrested while going to India or returning home. On international page, you have, this is regarding Taiwan official, military official killed in crash. This is regarding political developments in Israel. So you can skip these. Here you have US airlines face risk of extremist activity in Pakistan airspace. So this is a warning being given by Federal Aviation Administration that American airlines and their pilots should know that there is a risk involved in operating flights in Pakistan airspace due to extremist or militant activity. And this is Turkey approves Libya military deployment. So Turkish parliament has passed a bill approving a military deployment to Libya aimed at shoring up UN-backed government in Libya. So Turkey is supporting the government here, and it has given it military support, military deployment. So this has been approved by Turkish parliament too now. And then you have Lebanon receives Interpol arrest warrant for Ghoshan. So we had seen this is former Nissan boss Carlos Ghosn, who fled from Japan and reached Lebanon. So now Interpol arrest warrant has been issued against him, and Lebanon has also received it. On business page, you have sugar output drops by close to a third. So production in first 3 months of marketing year have been low, prices remain stable, exports are at good pace, but the output has dropped. So that is shown here in the maps, in the graphs too. This is regarding sugar production and sugar output. So sugar output though seems stagnant, but sugar production has increased. Then this is manufacturing sector activity rises in December. So manufacturing activity, that is known through Purchasing Managers Index to PMI, which is a private sector marketing manufacturing index as such. So here it is seen that it has improved in December 2019, but companies are cautious on 2020 outlook. And this is ONGC wins all seven oil gas blocks. So these were seven oil and gas blocks which were on offer in the latest bid round that saw just 8 bids coming. And state-owned ONGC took over all these blocks. So these were within India as such. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aisha.com. Thank you.